resistance and change often begin in art, and very often in our art, the art of words.
First National Book Awards was in 1950, and for 70 years, the National Book Awards have honored the best books in America, shining a light on exceptional books and their authors. The awards show us what we value, what we're interested in, what's important, and what has lasting power.
Books are the most powerful force in the universe, and history supports us.
You already won. You already won before the book even came out because you made it into a book.
In March, the foundation closed its doors alongside everyone else. We were going to distribute books to public housing authorities around the country. We had book up programs after school all around the nation. We had NBF Presents events in states and states and states and states. We had plane tickets. We had authors booked. We had audiences lined up. And so we very quickly, you know, regrouped. We had to make sure that we were dealing topically with the extraordinary issues that the country and world were facing. So we worked even more deeply with our publishing partners and with public libraries and public housing to make sure that those books, by hook or crook, got into the hands of the people who needed them.
So at the heart of all of National Book Foundation's education programs is the idea of access, and that we can be this point of connection for young people and books. Book Rich Environments is a collaboration between the National Book Foundation and the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development, along with some other nonprofit partners and other government agencies, to sort of change the fact that public housing authorities are often classified as book deserts. We work with publishing partners to secure a high quantity of donated books every year, which are then sent directly to 43 different public housing authorities across 27 different states.
Now that we are in this pandemic mode, you will be surprised how resilient and creative our public housing authorities are, along with their libraries. We know that many housing authorities are distributing nutritional meals and snacks to families. They're doing that practicing social distancing, of course. And so where you have families coming in to access meals, children are receiving like a portfolio of books and or backpacks of books along with a nutritional meal.
The young people in our programs are maybe even more excited to be getting books during this time when they're cut off from a lot of other resources they would usually have access to, whether that's school or library or community programming.
So this year, alongside the Academy for American Poets and the Community for Literary Magazines and Presses, we gave out over $3.5 million to literary arts organizations in crisis because of the pandemic. 282 organizations benefited from the support which was given to us by the Andrew W. Mellon Foundation.
How do writers get readings? How do writers move around and interact with audiences? How do writers talk to young people? At Mellon, we have very crucially believed that there is no culture without the word, and that there certainly is no justice without the word to give it form.
The Literary Emergency Fund came at a moment when I don't think I realized how much this organization, The Loft, needed it. This fund has allowed us to continue to serve and innovate in a time when a lot of people are having to cut back. And it allows us to continue to offer free programming, to tell stories, and to bring new community members in who right now are hungry to hear from each other and build community.
And through our public programs at National Book Foundation, we're thinking about adult audiences. How do we get adults excited about discovering new books, talking about books with their friends, and sort of using the ideas presented in National Book Award honored books to think more critically, to learn, to sort of connect with different things that are going on in this moment.
Through our Literature for Justice program, we've identified books about mass incarceration, about policing in America, to help people to understand what our carceral system looks like and who is impacted by it.
The nonprofit literary arts are important because it is through story that we understand each other and to move through difficult times like the one we're in.
If it's just one book that has made a difference in the community, that says a lot.
The book will never become obsolete, but there do need to be entities that are devoted to what is within the object of the book, and that thinks also about equality of opportunity to have access to the book and to the people who make them.
The National Book Awards is many things to many people. It is the greatest celebration that we have of literature. But for us, it's also our fundraiser. But it also powers book-rich environments. It powers Literature for Justice. It powers NBF Presents. It powers having a staff as devoted and dedicated as the one that we have, making sure that this work gets done. We're an institution that is in transition. We are an institution in the middle of a pandemic. We are a nonprofit. And while we're steady and we believe in our future, without support, you know, it is far less assured. And so we hope that tonight you'll consider making a donation of whatever you can. For some, that might be $5. For some, that might be $50,000. So we hope that you'll consider.